A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 5th May, on the front page you have PMO monitoring Rafael deal progress, not interference. So this is what the government says in the Supreme Court. So central government has submitted its response to review petitions in the Supreme Court. The Supreme Court had actually given its ruling on the Rafael deal. Rafael deal was brought before the Supreme Court that there is alleged corruption involved here, but the central government submissions here resulted in Supreme Court ruling in late 2018 that there is no corruption because the CAG, Comptroller and Auditor General of India, has given a clean chit to the deal. So it has looked into all the details and it has given its thumbs up. So that's why it said that there is nothing wrong in Rafael deal, no corruption, and it gave its ruling. But then immediately after the ruling, the next day, government also filed a correction that the CAG has not yet looked into the report. What they meant in the submission when the government said, it meant that CAG looks into reports. So it has not yet looked into Rafael deal. So that was the correction filed. And the opposition, they said that the petitioners, they said that this judgment is not correct because it is based on wrong submission or wrong assumption. So that is why review petitions were filed to review this judgment giving a clean chit to Rafael deal, and Supreme Court has accepted this review petitions and asked the government to respond to them, to the questions raised. So now central government has submitted its response following the Supreme Court's directive, and in this it says that when PMO is monitoring the Rafael deal, because the Rafael deal is a defense deal, you should know about the 36 Rafael jets which we are buying through government to government agreement from France. So this Rafael deal is a defense deal. So there was a defense, you know, Indian negotiating team which was negotiating the deal with the French side. But then PMO was also holding parallel negotiations with France, and the Indian negotiating team, the internal documents reveal that they raised their voice saying that this is compromising and this is undermining their position in negotiations with the French team. So on this, the government says that the PMO was monitoring Rafael deal progress and it was not interference. So this is what it says. And you know, it also says that the review petitions which have been accepted now, this could lead to revelation of closely guarded secrets relating to space, nuclear installations, strategic defense capabilities, operational deployments of forces, intelligence resources in the country and outside. So such are the statements given by the government, that if they reveal the details, they are not ready to reveal the price of Rafael deal to, they say that will reveal the secrets, the closely guarded secrets, while the French side had also clearly stated that there is no such agreement with France that they cannot reveal the detail, which was earlier the statement given by the government too, that the deal with France does not allow us to reveal the details. But that is how it is kept as a secret, so that there is no investigation in the Rafael deal. Also, the another aspect to it is, of course, the offset clause in which the Rafael deal, the company through which we are buying the Rafael fighter jets from France, it has to reinvest 30% of what it will gain into the country again. And that offset partner which it has selected is Reliance, on which again the former French president under whom the Rafael deal was finalized, he had stated that we were not given a choice in the Rafael deal offset clause partner. So the offset partner was suggested by us, the Anil Ambani group, and Indian side says that there was no such pressure. So all such revelations have also come. Then this is devastated Puri cutoff, relief work taken up on war footing. So this is regarding Cyclone Fani, which has struck Odisha coast, Puri in Odisha. So this was a very severe cyclonic storm which struck Puri, and it has left the electricity infrastructure destroyed by cyclone. So those are the details coming forth regarding the devastation caused here. Then this is bombers visited Kashmir, Kerala, Bengaluru. So this is Sri Lankan army chief who says that the suicide bombers who carried out the attacks on Easter Day in Sri Lanka, they had visited Kashmir and Kerala for some sort of training or to make some more links with other foreign outfits. Then on page 9 you have State owned new space creates a flutter among space startups. So this is new space, a new commercial entity which has been registered by Department of Space, a government entity, which was registered on March 6. New Space India Limited, NSIL in Bengaluru. So this is actually a surprise because already Department of Space has a commercial venture called Antriksh Corporation Limited, which was set up in 1992 to market the products and services of ISRO. So now a new commercial entity formed, there is no clarity on what would be its role. But then it is said that it has been established with authorized capital of 10 crores and a paid up capital of 1 crore. And two senior officials of Antriksh have been moved to new space in March 2019 to help the new venture get off the ground. And government has not given much detail regarding this entity. On page 10, you have more women voted in 9 states, election commission data. So highest figure recorded in Meghalaya, where more women have voted. So you can see this participation data being shown here for Manipur. Here you can see it was more than 53% of total vote cast by women were in Manipur and Puducherry in the second phase. On international page, you have 200 rockets fired from Gaza. So Israel has responded with airstrike on rocket launchers which have hit Hamas military posts now. So when rockets were launched at Israel by Gaza militants, Israel responded with airstrike. And this is North Korea fires short-range projectiles. So this is North Korea now. North Korea clearly stated it would not break its promise, but then since the talks have not been moving as expected between US and North Korea, now North Korea has fired short range missiles which it had halted for more projectiles had been halted for more than a year, but now it has started its tests again. Then on Sundays, you have this FAQ coverage, frequently asked questions. So first issue is steering away from diesel. So these are leading passenger vehicle markets such as European Union, which are opting for other fuels. So this question here is, what is the trend against this heavy polluter fuel in India? So that is diesel, which is a heavy polluter. So Maruti also recently decided that it would not be manufacturing diesel vehicles anymore when BS6 norms, also Bharat standard 6 norms, would come into effect. And this is points of conflict. This says, why has the Supreme Court given an ultimatum to Reserve Bank of India on loan defaulters? So under RTI, RBI also has to give information. So this is regarding that issue. Supreme Court has also ruled on the matter and has given an ultimatum to RBI to now. And this is chips at stake in the PepsiCo farmers fight. So this is regarding how PepsiCo has said that farmers have infringed on its rights and have grown registered potato varieties, which it uses for Lay's chips. So the farmers on the other hand say that PepsiCo has infringed on their rights. So this is regarding Protection of Plant Varieties and Farmers Right Act of 2001. So the detailed coverage on this is given here. This is very important. Then on Sundays, you have science and technology coverage. So important science and tech coverage here is IIT Delhi 3D prints human skin. So the model can reduce and even replace testing cosmetics on animals. So this is a significant development. 3D printing is an advanced technology in which India has now, IIT Delhi scientists have now 3D printed, bioprinted human skin models. And this says, why is Northeast India drying up rapidly? So decreasing monsoon rainfall is associated with natural changes in the subtropical Pacific Ocean too. So rainfall reduction over the last 36 years in Northeast India is associated with such phenomena, climate change. So this is a coverage on that. So there is no other coverage on the last page. So these are the important headlines. Thank you.